we have a right to discuss the future of this planet and what our options might be. And so that's what I do. That's what a lot of us do. And apparently there are those who don't like that, because just after I posted the previous video about the ETs coming out of the closet, I found myself in a intentionally orchestrated, very extremely precarious situation, life-threatening. And it was very clear to me that this was something intentional based on what I've been doing with these videos. And it was amazing, because it was right out in the open, in public. You don't expect something like that. You might expect, I've had situations where people try to lure me into very remote places. And I've had a lot of difficult situations, but this one was entirely different. This was really a whole different level of attempt to silence the discussion and the investigation and the vetting and the looking at our options. And I'm not paranoid at all. I never go around the day thinking someone's out to get me. I said, in fact, I just the opposite. I feel like nobody's out to get me at all. But this definitely was a case of someone was out to get me. And very, very unsettling situation. So it must have really, really struck a nerve, which I guess I did, because I started bringing in all the threads, the important threads, and put them all together, and into this one picture of how things may unfold in the future. And in doing that, it heightens a sense of, wait a minute, what are our options? In other words, this discussion is for the sake of examining our options. When we have every right to do that, nobody has a right to say we can't examine our options. Nobody. So, how did I survive the situation? By keeping my nerve, keeping my integrity, and I'm always saying I do not consent to any harm. I do not consent to any harm whatsoever. No consent to any harm ever. I don't consent to it. And I carried that through the situation, which got me through it. But I could easily see how, if I wasn't really strong, that the situation could truly deteriorate into a very much of a life-threatening situation, and maybe resulting in my death, actually. So it was not something that I look forward to. For sure, I'm not very happy about those who arrange that situation at all. And again, I say I don't consent to myself being harmed. I don't consent to anyone associated with me being harmed at all. No consent, zero. So those who want have that agenda, you better flee. Either that or sit down a satsang and listen. Either that or flee. Well, those are your options. The option of harm is not on the table at all. There's no consent to that. But it brought home the kind of the crystallizing of the situation. I said, everything we've talked about is true. It is what it is. It really is what we thought it is. And the pressure is on. And the necessity for sanctuary is there. I've been preaching the sanctuary for a long time, and saying there will come a time when we will absolutely need sanctuary, because there are some homicidal maniacs out there, and I just met one today, totally psycho, and very clever, very shrewd, catches you unaware. Seems to be very normal type, sort of friendly, etc., but a complete control freak, and tries to get you under their control and turn your attention to something very negative, that away from their own intentions. So they mislead you, thinking that the negative intentions are somewhere coming from somewhere else, and then you don't recognize what their intentions are, and they creep up on you like that. It's really, I saw the way that they work is well, you see it, and having seen it, it's something that to process, and would be helpful going forward. It was an educational experience for sure. But you don't expect it. Don't expect it. That is also for sure. So it's important for those who are aware of what's going on to be able to help others, because others are in the crosshairs too. The world is in the crosshairs. Those who are aware are in the crosshairs. And I used to poo-poo this. No longer. And I guess as people come out and say, hey, you know, this targeting is going on, then maybe people will start listening. Of course, nobody wants it to happen to them, but I didn't want it to. But it came about in a very, very weird and frightening way, for sure. So it's important to speak up about this and to push back and say, no, absolutely not. We will not vacate our bodies under any condition. Not voluntarily, not involuntarily, because we give no consent to it whatsoever. We're going to discuss the situation. We're going to vet the situation. We're going to look at our options, and we're going to choose the best option for ourselves, period. That's all there is to it. So at some point, I'll bounce back from this, and I'll be more fearless than ever. I didn't really get frightened. I didn't tremble. I didn't shake. But I've been trying to process it. It's stressful. It is stressful for sure. So what I've been aiming for is some sort of sanctuary where there's a high degree of safety and protection, and people do not it's just some kind of situation that has the right kind of vibration and consent level. Clarity, the right type of clarity, which enables people to speak up even more and alert the world even more and focus on the positive even more, because really the solution to this is to not focus on the negative at all, because that you're playing their game when you do that. It's not to focus on any trauma you've ever had, because you're playing their game when you do that. You're bringing up memories of trauma. The thing to do is to turn the page and to laugh at it all and say, it was all unnecessary. Everything we've experienced in existence has been completely unnecessary. And to celebrate that fact, we have to shift from the negative to the positive, from the no to the yes. The emphasis has to shift. And so I have been aiming for that shift. We cannot simply keep dredging up all our traumas, because we've all had a ton of them. And the difficulties. It's been a road of horrors, definitely. We all know that it has been. But it's time to say, hey, it's time to step off that death march, onto the road of very easy, beautiful, blissful pathway, and to start celebrating that. That is where safety actually is. Safety is not on the old path of trauma. It's not there, that is for sure. And really, I was face to face with an extremely traumatic situation today. And in no uncertain terms, it was laid out for me in sort of a parallel, clever way, what the intent was, which is that it was to kill me and to bury me somewhere. And but it was very done such a sneaky, clever way, you know, wow. And I just got out of there, left quickly, did my business, and got out of the situation. And they were none too pleased about that. That is for sure. So we do have to be. Our intent needs to be strengthened. Our yes to stepping off this path of trauma needs to be strengthened. Our no to not consenting to any harm needs to be strengthened. And we cannot engage. What happened was I engaged too much just by being polite. It was just simply a polite engagement. This whole thing was being pressured on me, and just to be civil and polite, I just was trying to be polite. But the warning signs were extreme, and what I really needed to do was just make a statement like, hey, I don't consent to any victimization whatsoever, period, and just say that. We're not used to doing that in the world. And when I talk about a big boost, this is part of it, is we need to feel empowered to speak up directly immediately and tell people where we stand, whereas we don't do that. I was caught up in this politeness, and that could have been deadly, actually. And I realized there have been other situations in my life where I was put in extraordinarily bad situations because I was very polite and I was willing to listen to people's sob stories about, and gradually they got into a more and more negative, deeper, deeper spot, and more and more rage, more and more rage, and they were trying to snap. They tried to get into extreme rage where they suddenly snap, and that's when they whack you like that. I saw that. That's actually what was taking place, and I was able to get out of there before the guy snapped. So you have to be proactive, and we as a culture are not taught that anymore. It used to be in the past when things were really wild, wild west, you needed to be proactive. People would just say, I accept the sanctuary of Christ or something. They would just make their intent, state their intent very clearly when they were in, you know, very dangerous situations. The world has always been a very dangerous place for those who have asserted the truth and the true path to salvation. We need to be able to disengage when the situation is clear that you're dealing with a psycho that has malevolent intent. You need to make just a positive affirmation of what your stance is, and then boom, that's it. That's it. No more engagement. Now, I was in a situation where I was working, and I had to accomplish something, and so I was felt sort of trapped. But even then, hindsight's 20/20. But as it was happening, the way it unfolded was so clever that it was just a progressive sense of alarm gradually building. But we always feel so dutiful, right? That we're supposed to finish what we're working on. This is another problem. That's what kept me engaged for too long. I should have gotten out of there. As soon as I heard him suddenly turn completely weird and homicidal, really, I should have gotten out of there and just said, okay, I'm done, and boom, 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 go. Don't give him time to build up that rage, because what I saw was that he was actually working on himself getting into a state of rage. He was trying to enrage himself and was working on it, actually trying to build it up. And I saw that he was trying to get to a point where he would suddenly completely snap and become homicidal. And at that, fortunately, I was able to get out of there before that took place. So it's important that people, when they see that the intent is malevolent and they're dealing with someone who is following the path of annihilation, you need to state your path clearly right up front and then say, that's it. And we need to do that. And when I talk about an ambassador of certitude, we need to go into a training with such an ambassador of certitude to have that. Now, we used to have it. I said, in Christianity, they used to be much better at it. The saints, they knew how to protect themselves. They were under threat. They were under threat. And they knew how to protect themselves by invoking their intent and saying what their consent was and what it wasn't. And they weren't shy about doing it. But we here, based on all this culture, is we feel like somehow we're supposed to be victimized. We're supposed to be nice. We're supposed to be civil. We're not supposed to say anything that's kind of weird or like that. We can't just say, I consent to the path of accepting reality as it is, and I do not consent to any harm befalling me whatsoever. I refuse to play the victim. I'm not consenting to play the victim at all. Something like that. People say, what are you talking about? You're nuts. But you have a right to affirm your position, your spiritual position. The problem is we don't have training for that right now. And I would love to go into training for that and be able to do that and help others get into that. Because it's necessary. I see now it is necessary. I cannot deny it anymore. I cannot deny it anymore. I've directly experienced what some of you have told me you've experienced. Some situations where you were targeted. And looking back, I have many times, but it was like accidents, trying to arrange accidents and various things. But this was a whole different ball game, a totally different ball game. It's face to face with malevolence. And the intent became clear, what they intended, what their intent was. And I said, wow, is that possible? Really? Really? And they said, well, you know what? I'm not going to stick around to find out. I'm out of here. So it would be great to have some training. And so we start protecting ourselves. We need to protect ourselves. That is true. That is true. I'm on board with that now. I'm really on board with that. And I'm going to ask for that training to take place. I believe I can understand it. I believe I can get it. And then I'll pass it on. It needs to be passed on right now. It needs to be disseminated. And hopefully if I can get some training how to do that, and then it will be disseminated and people will start saying, hey, this is important. We need to know how to do this, because as far as I'm concerned, the ETs who are very aware at a certain level of monitoring the world and aware of what's threatening their plans, apparently they don't like their plans being brought to light and are willing to take severe steps to keep their plans under wraps. And again, we have every right to be aware of what their plans are. We have every right to discuss these plans and discuss our plans and discuss our destiny and discuss our options. We have every right to do that. Nobody has the right to try to intimidate us not to, or try to bully us or threaten us into not doing that. So we need to assert our rights, and we need to exercise our rights. And I can see that we need to protect ourselves in exercising our rights, because some people don't like that. obviously. So when it's asked what kind of help do we need, I hope I'm answering this question of what type of help do we need going forward. It is, we need the help of being able to protect our rights. Assert and protect our rights, and there has to be, there is a spiritual way to do that. There is. As I've said, consent is the key. Consent is the key. And losing your awe, any sense of awe towards the ETs, realizing they're not superior to us, they're actually inferior. And we don't have to submit to anything that they try to press upon us. And just getting up this whole sense of understanding what we're truly entitled to, which is true safety, which is reality, which is where nothing real can be threatened. We're entitled to that, absolutely entitled to that. We have to assert our entitlements, and cannot be let the ETs and their proxies here push us around at all. And I wasn't able to stand up to this guy. I played the nice guy type of thing, which it's not right anymore. It doesn't work anymore. I don't think that works anymore. Doesn't work anymore. We have to be more assertive of our rights and of our entitlements. And so maybe this, they will go in this direction, and also celebrate our upcoming freedom, which is to accept the path of gravitating back to accepting reality as it is. That's a tremendous thing. Accepting that path is tremendous. The first couple steps are difficult, but after that it's a celebration. And we also do need to be able to effectively assert our rights without being harmed by doing so. So I'm continuing to process this highly educational experience, and I realize that people probably will be pressured. Obviously the pressure is on, right on me, severely right there. So there it is. I mean, Exhibit A. Exhibit A. So the way forward seems to be starting to clarify now. Starting to clarify. I'm starting to see justification for it. I talk about an ambassador of servitude, an avatar, a great guru, someone in the world who will help us. And I do see there's a practical side to it, that I'm aware of those in general who are interested in this type of subject matter, and I'm aware that their capability to withstand the pressure is somewhat iffy. Even my capacity was somewhat iffy. I sailed through it pretty well, but it could be a lot better. Like I said, I should have cut it short immediately. Because there were signs right off the bat, actually. I just said, but the guy pretended to be so friendly and engaging, like he really wanted to engage me in conversation. I said, well, I'll be a nice guy and go along with his desire to engage. He just seems like a real talkative guy. And then suddenly, it took an extremely dark turn and bizarre turn. What he was saying, it was just like, wow. So the sort of friendly engagement up front, it's just a pretext to make you feel like guilty if you don't engage what they're talking about further on. So you have to be very aware right now and have your protection up front at all times. At all times. Because most crazy, weird people, unstable people, you can see them coming. You can see them coming. Bandwidth has gone down to nothing. Now, why does it keep doing that? And you can just say, I'm not going to engage with this one. But there are some who are able to get you to engage with them, thinking that they're like some really nice, some person that's very personable kind of thing. And you get pulled into it. And then suddenly they start pulling you down this very dark alley, as it were. So you literally have to be very adamant about your rights. Know your path. Know your path. And at all times, be asserting your path right now. And we need help with that. When it's asked, what kind of help do we need? We need help with that, actually. I need help with it. I'll be the first one to admit it. I definitely need to upgrade that way. Big time. Big time. I'm asking for it right now. I want to upgrade. Because I don't want that to happen again. Absolutely not. I want them to flee at the even sight of me. Like they won't even... You know, I'd be terrified to even pull something like that. Try to make an attempt. It was really an attempt. It was an attempt on my life is what it really was. It failed. And I don't want another attempt to be made, that is for sure. And I said, hey, their option, they got an option. They can flee. They can flee. And that's the option. Either don't approach me that way at all with that intent or flee. Those are your options. So, I want to upgrade it. And it's up to each one of you, but I would say, just from my perspective, what I've seen is everybody needs an upgrade. Everybody needs an upgrade, because the level of deceit that I experienced today was hardcore. Really dirty pool. Really, really dirty pool. Wow. that's as bad as it gets, really. That is probably about as bad as it gets as far as deception. Deception. Complete psychopath. Complete psychopath. And that's tough to spot. It is tough to spot. And yet that's what's being employed right now, obviously. So I need an upgrade. It's plain and simple. Justification for an upgrade is right there. And I would suspect that most people in the world need an upgrade. Because if I need an upgrade, probably most do. Because I'm pretty clear about the situation, yet I don't quite feel entitled to adamantly stand for that right up front. See, we don't have it up front yet. There's a problem with that unfrontness, which gives an opening to psychopaths. It really does. Like I said, ordinary crazy people, you give them you realize, hey, I'm getting out here. But the others have a way of seeming to charm their way into conversation in such a way, and you got to spot it and cut it short immediately. You don't want to be paranoid. You don't want to be shutting everybody out. Not at all. But you do have to carry that intent in front. The frontal has to have that intent, and right now it doesn't have it. We're too conciliatory, too compromising, too wishy-washy, too full of guilt, too full of needing to have good manners, and all this kind of stuff, and we don't have the capacity to disengage, boom, like that. We don't. And we need to practice it. We need to practice it. So, my prayer is that going forward, I will have a situation that where I'm able to be trained and practiced and shown how to do this, and then share it with the world. Super strong necessity right now. Super strong. And maybe people, I actually shared this experience with one person, and they actually had a, they told me of a similar experience that they were aware of that was very similar and was just absolutely crazy and horrifying, very frightening. Just recently. I suspect that a lot of you have had experiences like this. I bet you when we start sharing this information of how to stand up to this pressure, this bully, people will start coming out and saying, hey, I've had this experience. Not that we want to dwell on it, but maybe we can just say, yeah, I really did have this horrifying experience, and I want to upgrade my capacity to deny consent to any harm. You know, to deny any consent. I do not consent to any harm, period. I want to upgrade my capacity to disengage from this much, much earlier, much, much earlier, and much more authoritatively, without any doubt. So I bet that there's an enormous market for this, enormous amount of people who just are thirsting for this capacity to stand up to this type of situation in a much more effective way. I don't like the way I stood up to it. I really don't. I got through it. I'm alive, but I don't like the way I stood up to it. Really, I don't. And the guy was a total control freak. That's why I see it as psychopaths or extreme control freaks. They try to get you under their control and get you just to simply listen in a controlling way. It's different than satsang. Different than, people are free to leave satsang anytime. Leave, click, pause, go away, stop watching. Whatever you want to do is perfectly okay with me. But it's a different thing because in the times I kind of challenged the situation, I felt a fury. And I tried to turn it, I tested it, say, what's going on? And there was a fury there, like how that I was supposed to submit to this will or intent that he had. I was supposed to submit to it. And he was just leading me step by step by step to submit to it. And I kept cutting it short, and he got really agitated, really irritated. And then when I was ready to leave, that got extreme rage that I was not under his control. The steps had not worked. That I guess he was used to using these steps. I don't know if he was a serial killer or something like that. Very possible. And he was used to these steps working. It didn't work in my case. And that was, he didn't like that at all. Not at all. So, but We don't have to humor people anymore. We shouldn't have to humor. This is a serious situation in the world right now. It is a super serious because the ET agenda is about ready to, the whole plan is about ready to be implemented, and this world is about to be taken over, period. And it is about, and it, the demand is that we will submit to this new world order. That will be the demand, period. And those people have talked about how serious it will be. They're right. They're right. It is going to be entirely serious. People have had dreams about being in re-education camps and being starved to death, etc. They're right. They're right. Those who have talked about the crises coming up, they are right. And we shouldn't demean them by their seeing what is in store. It's not negative. It's not anti-spiritual. That's total BS that people say that somehow you're not being spiritual by being aware of what's going on. It's not true. Being very spiritual. It's just that we don't want to dwell on it per se. We want to be aware of it, discuss it, vet it, but also see what our options are. And only look at it in the context. Okay, what are our positive options? How can we stand up to this? How can we say no to this? That's what it's all about. It's how can we say no to it? How can we say, I don't consent to any of this. I don't consent to any harm. None. I refuse to consent to this. I refuse to consent to the demand. I vacate my body. I refuse to submit to your terms. I refuse to submit to your agenda, to your belief system, to your insanity. I refuse to consent to that. That's what it's all about, is to build up your integrity and clarity and will, so you're operating from the standpoint of will And you say, I refuse to consent to this. My will is to accept reality as it is and not to work on some hypothetical problem. So I'm still, you know, I'm still intact. I'm a little bit shaken up, a little bit nervous, a little bit, not badly, but I'm not happy at all by what took place. Not at all happy about this. As we used to say, it's a real bummer. It's a real bummer. Right in your own hometown, you know, this is not supposed to happen in your backyard, right? I don't like that at all. So I will pursue remedies for this. And I'll get with it as soon as possible. As soon as possible. There's got to be some remedies. And so perhaps, hopefully, and I want this to be so, this line of willingness is going to bear some fruit. Bear some fruit. It's not all about sitting in satsang, listening and clarifying. That is great. That is great. But it's not, that is not the only thing there is to the situation. There's more depth to it. We need to protect ourselves. Period. Period. We have to accept protection. We have to be willing to assert our freedom from harm, freedom from threat. We have to assert it. And we're not used to doing that. So we have to change that around. Have to change it around. And we will do it. We will change it around. I will change that around. The only problem is that people think you're completely weird, like you're paranoid or crazy or something, just to, you know, be asserting, hey. But that's because they don't understand. That's because they see submission to the New World Order as some super positive thing. Like it's graduation time for the world, that this is something we've all aimed for, and this is something that's going to catapult us into the golden age. That's how they see it. Not so, not so. It's going to end up in their slavery and bondage to darkness and a feeling that they have they're not entitled to reality at all. They have to keep slaving away on this hypothetical. That's what will happen. That's what will happen. I'm always surprised when steps are taken to try and silence me, as they have been throughout my life. I just say, well, the nerve of these entities, the nerve, you know, what are they thinking? You know, they're nuts. It just makes me more adamant, you know. And I don't expect them to really target me. Let's be crazy to do that. And they are crazy. They absolutely are crazy. Because, it just strengthens my resolve to be even more adamant. But really, they have no conscience. They have no shame. They have no understanding of where help comes from at all. I mean, they're nuts to try and silence someone who's actually willing to help them. They don't understand where their help comes from. They really don't. But we cannot humor them and play along with their supposed willingness. Cannot do that. We have to set some standards, set some rules, set some guidelines, and say, you know, this is what we're doing, period. And I have to get on board with that now. There has to be, because we cannot dwell on the negative too much as far as trauma. We have to acknowledge it, but not get submersed in it. There's a certain line we don't want to cross. We have to be the positive, the optimistic, the celebratory has to be primary. Has to be primary. That has to be primary. We cannot get pulled down into our traumas, because then that puts us, that starts weakening us, and we start seeing vulnerable. And we're trying to remember when we were like really vulnerable, more vulnerable than now. Well, we're not so vulnerable now. So let us not try to pull back from memory times when they're too vulnerable, really vulnerable in the past. Turn the page and focus on making sure that we cut short the trauma now, the attempts to traumatize. Cut it short and cut it shorter and shorter and shorter and shorter and shorter until we say nothing at all. And we can be helped by that. I didn't expect things to go in this direction, but they have. I didn't expect Ambassador Sir to help us in this way, but you know what? They could. They really could. They really, as a matter of fact, that's probably the most important way they could help. But I'm very clear about salvation. Very, very clear. Crystal clear about it. and yet I'm weak at this one area I'm weak at, and that was exposed today. I'm not totally weak. I have potential to be very strong, but I should have done a better job, and so I'm weak at it. I'm weak at it. So if you're weak at something, what do? You have to get better at it. That's where I need to get better. That's probably where a lot of people need to get better, along with also clarification. That people are not so strong in this clarification, but it will come. It will come. Some are starting to at least be able to conceptualize it, which is the first step, and be able to bring it to mind and say, okay, so this, it's coming. I can see, and those are watching the videos, it's starting to come. It doesn't come all at once, just right away, but they're step by step, you're starting to get it in focus. It's really like a microscope, and you're working to get this in focus, and it seems like it keeps moving, and you get a little glimpse, you get a little closer, you're starting to bring it into focus, which is, that is the path. Bring it into focus is the path, and making efforts to do so is the path. Of course, you won't get it boom like that right away, but it gets better and better and better. Now is the time when it's really going to come into focus. And at the same time, we need to assert our true entitlements, our true rights here, because there's a massive push to disentitle us, if that's a word, to strip us of our entitlements, to strip us of our rights, to get us to submit to enslavement. And there's an enormous pressure, and I felt that today, and the pressure, when people say that they feel the world, afraid of the world being cold, massive genocide care, et cetera, et cetera. Well, I experienced that firsthand, the intent and the will to do that, and they firsthand today. It's not a joke. It is not a joke. This is coming. This is coming. And I've been warning the world about this, that people have been developing an inner rage that they have inside them, and they're trying to be able to get that to overpower their reticence to commit homicidal acts, so that they snap. And all these games, super violent games, have been a way to develop this inner snap point, where they feel no conscience whatsoever to do it. Now, down in Latin America, Mexico, there are many young people who are able to reach that snap point. They use drugs like methamphetamine, stuff like, to help them get to that snap point, where they just commit massacres without any conscience whatsoever, like they're robots. That is coming. That is coming very strongly. And I was completely aware. I was aware now, in hindsight too, of that's exactly what was happening in my situation. Someone was trying to work themselves into the snap point, where they would simply commit murder right out in public, in it like that, in a split second, with no mercy, nothing, just an instantaneous act, violent act, boom, like that. Maybe when your back is turned, even hit you from behind, they have no, just a complete sense of annihilation, boom, annihilate right now, like that. That is coming in the world. That is truly coming. And so those people who have seen that are not being paranoid. They're being realistic. And I praise those who are realistic enough to have the courage to see the future and face the future and see that this is what is coming. And there is a way to protect yourself from that. Absolutely is. Absolutely is. And we will get that. And we will not suffer that. We will not suffer that. We will say no to that. No consent to that. None whatsoever. None. And they say, well, you're going to be completely annihilated by God in the future. You're going to be completely excluded. And this, you better go this way. Otherwise, you're going to face total annihilation. We're going to say, no, we got the clarity. This is a total lie. This existence is just a hypothetical problem symbolizing annihilation, which will never happen in reality. We're clear about that. We do not consent to any harm. We assert our entitlement. We are entitled to accept reality as it is, and no harm at all, no threat at all. And stand up for ourselves here. Stand up for ourselves here and everywhere. It's time to stand up for ourselves. And we need help. We need help, because that's what's lacking in the world. I can't find anybody in the world that truly has that stand up for themselves and entitlement that is powerful and is profound, and that is teaching us how to do that, really. There's a great lack of that in the world, an extreme lack of that. It's not only about talking about non-duality, blah, 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 blah. There's also another aspect of this situation. I experienced it today. there is a massive movement in subtle realm, in this world, in the subtle realms, to exterminate those who refuse to bow to the authority of the New World Order that is coming. It's absolutely, that is the plan. That is the plan. Very cut and dried. And we have every right to say no to that and to reject it and refuse it. And we're soft on this. We're soft on it. Very soft. And so that adamancy needs to come to the front. Needs to come to the front. And I got a strong push that way today. A very strong push. And maybe I'll detail it at some point. I don't want to, you know, submerge myself in it. So we will be very adamant about this going forward. Very adamant. Continue the adamancy, the advocacy of this. And refuse any harm. Absolutely refuse. And accept help. Accept legitimate help. And we should be able to recognize the help, because the help will click, and we will be given the tools we need. When you get the tool you need, you know, oh, thank you very much, because this is exactly what I really needed, this tool. And those who dispense those tools, those are truly our helpers, and we will be able to recognize that, yeah, these are the tools we need. And maybe it's like learning to play golf or something. You need to learn how to use these tools. And once you learn how to use them, you can say, hey, I can play pretty well. Now I have the tools. I know how to stay safe here. I know how to stay safe here. Because this game is going to get really weird really fast. And I just experienced the weirdness really weird firsthand today. That was a full dose of weirdness, believe me. Doesn't get much weirder than that. And yeah, there's a whole agenda there. It's all laid out, step, and I was being led down the primrose path, and I was just, you know, I was too confident and centered in myself. I just was cutting it short, but they kept trying to, come on, you know, push. And I was able to get out of there. We can do better. We can do better. We will do better. All right. Very great. That's the morning talk today. And gosh, seems like we're stepping on a lot of toes here, which sometimes you got to do that. You know, if somebody's putting their toes underneath our feet, keeping us from walking, then I guess we're going to have to step on some toes if they keep doing that. Because we have every right to gravitate and take the path of accepting reality as it is. We have every right. No one has a right to say we can't do that. Nobody. All right. Very great. That's it.